So you're welcome to come speak to items that are not on the agenda. If you're not sure what's on the agenda, you can get an agenda or ask us. And with that in mind, we'll go ahead and begin the evening's session.
Mr. Mayor Jim Connish, I'd like you to know, Mr. Mayor, that on Monday, May 26th, Alachua County County Court Judge is going to take a look at your utility tax scheme. As you know, I've told you, I think you have a lot of problems with it. And of course, you've ignored that, sir. I encourage all citizens to take a look at a GRU document that explains the way the utility bills are calculated and look very closely at the methodology. To get ready for this litigation, I asked the City of Gainesville to admit that they in fact have a document explaining their methodology and that it's accurate. The response I got is very interesting. While they admit to having documents, they deny that the documents are accurate. And I want to read you a quote. In the past, GRU was under-collecting municipal public service tax on the gas utility by not including the gross receipts tax in the pyramiding calculation, but this has been corrected as of September 14th. Out of the sunshine, there's been a series of meetings, apparently, where you have decided to up the utility tax without any public input or discussion. That is probably illegal. And you're doubling down on it while you're claiming you're reducing upward pressure on the bills. I will strike this down, sir. In the paper, since this is Doctor's Day, I think it's very helpful to take a look at an article by Thomas K. Young, a physician. I want to read you a couple of excerpts. It would have been far more informative to learn Hutchinson's views on the one-third of the GRU ratepayers, a large number of them his constituents, living outside the city and paying exorbitant rates to a mismanaged and unregulated monopoly. Instead, he and Hawkins were asked to nitpick Representative Perry's draft proposal. Gainesville was a fiscal mess before the biomass plant, but this is the clincher. Conceived of the committed environmentalist need to do something, midwifed by a variety of special interests, and railroaded through a reluctant public service commission, it arrived as an unnecessary and gruesomely expensive problem. Protected by an ironclad 30-year contract to deliver all the energy it can produce at prices 4 to 5 times greater than comparable and far cleaner natural gas plants, this unwanted visitor will impoverish this area for years to come, costing the average ratepayer $8,000 each. If the voters of Gainesville wish to prolong the myth that they can competently supervise the utility through the ballot box and with the help of the Gainesville Sun, so be it. Otherwise, GRU becomes a honeypot where local politicians use monopoly power to carve up the ratepayers in the unincorporated areas. And I skip one quote. He believes GRU needs adult supervision. Now, this is a physician, sir, on Doctor's Day. You need to listen to it. And I want to tell you one last thing. When Representative Perry appeared before his colleagues, without any shame, he pointed out that his wife wants something down. Now, he stood right here and told you this. Mrs. Perry has had enough. Thank you.
There you go.
It's official.
Thank you for your comment.